Hi there, folks, and thanks for clicking on Close Up. In just a couple of days, Governor Lynch will unveil his spending plan for the next 2 years. And many do expect that this will be a painful budget that will cut jobs and programs. But the Republican majority says their plan not only includes spending reductions, but also tax breaks. And Democratic leadership has concerns that could be just plain reckless.
It can certainly mean that our most vulnerable citizens will be left without essential services. It certainly will mean downshifting of costs to local municipalities. That means higher property taxes, and not just higher property taxes for homeowners, but higher property taxes for small businesses, which is one of their big costs.
This cycle presents us an opportunity to rethink government, to look at programs that have just been allowed to roll forward budget cycle after budget cycle and say, are they doing what the people need to be done? And if they are they doing it in the most efficient way possible? We've had committees working on this, quite frankly, before we organized as a legislature.
And the leadership also addresses an issue that certainly could get messy, the Republican effort to force the Attorney General to join the fight on health care reform. It's an issue that could wind up in court. Also on the program, former Ambassador Terry Shoemaker joins us to talk about the ever-unfolding situation in Egypt. And with Mubarak now gone, he says this is a critical time for the entire region.
Best case is that there is a stable transition, like Secretary of State Clinton has repeatedly advocated. We need more democracy in Egypt. We're supportive of more democracy, she has said repeatedly through the last 10 days. We want that to happen, but we don't want it to happen overnight. I think an awful lot of time and commentary is focused on what's going to happen with Mubarak. Frankly, I'm more concerned about what's going to happen next.
Also, a look ahead to our kickoff of Commitment 2012. It's a special set to air on Monday at 7 o'clock. We'll have a look at the field of potential candidates and the questions facing New Hampshire's role in this primary. All of it on Close Up, Sunday at 10.